Excellent.
Hi, I'm MXD, and I make 3D animations with Source Filmmaker here on YouTube. And today I show you how I made these fun and weird videos. Maybe it's also interesting for new YouTubers, or you're just in general interested in this kind of stuff. I wanted to do this for a long time, so here it is, finally. You may already know some of my videos. I made this, for example.
Heavy has come to me. Elephant enemy. Sniper is speed. Yes, motherfucker.
Or this.
Sniping's a good job, mate. Out of doors. I guarantee you'll not go hungry. Because at the end of the day, long as there's two people left on the planet, someone is going to want someone dead.
I will show you my secret techniques and how I start from this and end up like this. But first, let's go to Steam and let's search for Source Filmmaker. Easy download, and now we can start it. Just click here. And now you're cursed. Something will eventually happen and we can't avoid it. This whole software is weird. Okay, let's start. How do I make animations? I change the map. Then I add some models.
Why are we still here?
Now we need just some lights and pixels, and we're almost done. I prepared something and I wanna make some tiny little animation. It doesn't supposed to be good. I just wanted to show you how fast and easy you can create something in a short amount of time. Quality content.
Quality content.
Let's imagine, I have a great idea.
Yes!
Then I scrap everything cause it
sucks! Ah! Oh! What?
Apologies.
Let your dreams come true.
Sometimes I dream about cheese.
Or you're just lazy and take an idea from someone else like I did. I made a model out of this comment and now I make an animation shot out of this. Write down a small script and you're good to go. The very first thing you wanna do is adding some models. Main characters, camera, only important stuff. I create some very cheap animations and make a layout for the scene. This technique is called layouting and storyboarding. You just add the most important models and animate them as cheapest as possible. So the animator, me, knows later what's actually happening. Big companies like Pixar also do it like this. You save a lot of time later, and not just that, also you have some idea how the final scene may look and feel like. Sometimes I kinda even skip this step and make final poses, so this saves even more time. I always think ahead and try to save as much time as possible, and it's really easy with SFM. The tools, the rigs, it makes it so easy.
Peace.
Go to hell, wanker.
Mon Dieu! What the hell?
Ah! Oh, this is my swamp!
What?
Lights. Okay, let's add a few lights to my scene. This shot from the movie Coco has over 10k lights. Other shots as well, like this graveyard with over 18k lights. Let's imagine having over 1k lights on SFM.
Oh. Ah.
Sometimes I see renders with one light like this. You can do definitely better. I will show you how. And please, don't just add one bright light. So here I change a little bit the brightness and the shadow and color.
Light.
Ooh, yeah.
Volumetric light from the right. Another light.
Get into it.
Bottom left.
Love it.
Ooh. Colors. Light. Top light. Light. Bottom light.
Put them under the ground, put them wherever you want. And you have decent lights. Yeah, here's some my yes. Finished light project. Why don't we also add some background stuff? I love this theme. And yeah, as you can see, I added even some lights in these props, so it makes everything more realistic. And actually, this whole thing looks like this. Behind the scenes, it looks sometimes really funny. Especially some background animations, or in general, everything that's out of camera can look weird. I mean, why should I bother animating those feet if no one will see it?
If fighting is sure to result in victory, then you must fight. Sun Tzu said that. Oh, and I'd say he knows a little more about fighting than you do, pal. Oh, this is mine. Two, three. No.
Why are we still here?
That were just a few clips behind the camera. It's almost the same as maps in video games. You build your scene, props, everything for the final camera shot, but only for this camera shot. Speaking of maps, some maps has some built-in props that cannot be selected, removed, or you even wanna have your own map. Here, this crate. I hate it. This needs to be removed. Use Hammer, the map editor for Source games. Select the prop, remove it, compile the map. Done.
Gotta move that gear up!
Oh no. What's this? Why is it? What's up with the memory? There are just two models and one camera. Do you remember the beginning? Here it is, the curse. Maybe even a spooky ghost. I don't know. Look, what happened here? This is a very old project, and some characters are deformed, a Slenderman, but worse, I don't know. The only way to fix this is by replacing the models and exporting the animation. Why do some maps have missing buildings and props? Don't even think about it to load the map Badlands. SFM will crash for sure. Can I have some normal sentry rotations?
Nope. Nope.
Add another model. Fake axis. Place it wherever you want your rotation. Weld the rotation point to your sentry and now animate. Wow, that was so easy. Do you think particles are easy in SFM? No, me neither. I just wanna change the color. And now understand anything of this. At least I know some of the basics. So let's just change the color on every f***ing subparticle. I don't even wanna start talking about beards or cosmetics and glitching heads. At least the community is still active and fix many issues, fix cube maps, beards. But there's one thing I don't understand. After all these years, cursed models. Seriously, I have this Solly, created an animation point. Everything works how it's supposed to be. He moves like here and there, normal, yes, yes. That's good. Now I skip many seconds and go over here. Let's do the same again. Why? I don't understand. Really, I don't understand. The only way to fix this is to copy the crossed model. Paste it, and now the animation works as usual.
No, that's it.
There's something even worse. Here, look at this. Over 100 heavy models. With heads, weapons, everything. Over 30 likes in this shot. Everything works fine except the 10 FPS. I don't care. Now we have a way easier scene. Thanos heavy, some towns, blood, but oh no. Here it is. LRB3, I don't know. If you get this on your project, it's over. SFM crashes. Nobody actually knows how, when, and where this error appears. There's even a workshop model for it, and this says all. Hey, I'm glad you're still here, and there is a lot of more to cover in SFM, but that's enough for now. Tell me if you want more of this type of video. This whole thing is made possible by you beautiful people, the gaming enthusiasts, Alias Cabbage, Shadow Machine and Cupcake Monkey TF2, including all my other supporters. You are the best and make this whole YouTube animation gaming channel stuff even more enjoyable. Patreon and YouTube memberships helps a lot, and you will even gain some sneaky early access. My private drive link. Donator raffles as well, with keys and side hats. Oh, and I also stream more often now, so consider subscribing, clicking the bell, so you can be number one at spamming.